Welcome to this week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. In this week's episode, we will be learning how to write formulas that will help us allocate multiple payments made against the same invoice or multiple payments made by customers across multiple invoices. So we will learn how to write the formula in this video. If you have not subscribed to this channel yet, please do. And now let's get started with this week's episode. Now, just to set the stage for this video, we are going to use the Invoice Tracker Excel template that is available for free to download from Indzara.com. I will also put a link to the video and also the page where you can download this template in the video description, so please check that out. And in this template that we have published a while ago, the invoices are recorded here. Each invoice is entered in a separate row, and then the customer for that each invoice is named here, and then each invoice will have an invoice date and a due date and the invoice amount. And then the paid amount is the amount that has been paid so far by the customer, and that has been entered directly in this column. And then the outstanding amount and what's the status and everything will be calculated by the template using formulas automatically. Now, in this template, we have entered the paid amount directly as a user input, right? So what we're going to do now is to extend this template further by saying, what if this invoice number one, the customer did not make one payment, made in multiple payments? So what will you do? If the customer, for example, has multiple invoices, like for example, customer three has three invoices, and they actually pay together across multiple invoices in their payments. So how do you make sure that you can track the payments that the customers made and also allocate correctly to each invoice and calculate the outstanding amount? So that's what we're going to learn in this video. Okay, so now I have removed a lot of the sample data, so I've kept it really simple so that we can clearly follow what's going on with the formula. And the first option here is the payment by invoice. So I'm going to go into the sheet where I've already created a table. So if you want to track the customer who is making multiple payments for each invoice, then you will set up a table like this with just three columns: invoice number, payment date, and amount that the customer paid for that. So this means for invoice number one, the customer made two payments, one on December 5th for $100, one on December 8th for $200. And similarly for invoice number two, there were two payments made, $200 and $400 on different dates. Now, we want to make sure that our invoice tracker correctly calculates the paid amount for each invoice. So first we're going to do a simple SUMIF function. So we're going to use the table that we've already created. So before I do that, I just want to inform that this is an Excel table where you can enter more and more rows and it'll automatically expand. So the formula will work only if you have created like a table, and we have named the table as T_PYMT_INV. So this is kind of important because this will come through in the formula. So we're going to write in the first cell in the table for the paid amount column, SUMIF, open parenthesis. Now we need to provide the range. The range is going to be the invoice number column in this table and comma. And what we're going to search for is the specific invoice number here. So I click here and you will see that in the formula, it says at invoice number and then comma. Now, what are we going to sum? We're going to sum the payment amount here, close parenthesis and enter. So now we can see that the formula is correctly calculating $300 for the first invoice. So if you go back here, first invoice, 100 plus 200, 300. Invoice number two, 200 plus 400, $600. So I'm going to go back here, and the second invoice says $600. Third and the fourth invoices, no payments have been made, so they are zero. So this is how you can calculate the paid amount if you have customer making multiple payments for a single invoice. The second scenario we are going to deal with is a little bit more complicated, where the customer is making payment across invoices. So that's a little bit complicated, but we will deal with that as well with the formula. So I'm going to first delete the formula in this now, and then we will start entering a new formula for that scenario. Before I do that, the payments made by customer are tracked in this table. So you will create a similar table and say customer, when they made the payment date, and the amount that they paid on that day. So now I have customer one making a payment of $100 on December 5th, $1,000 on December 8th. Similarly, customer two makes two payments on two different dates. These payments are not specific to any invoices. We are going to allocate according to the sequence, the payment made, and then we will just keep allocating the amounts for each invoice. So we go back here. This is where we are going to write the formula. So the first customer, the customer one has two invoices, invoice one and invoice two, which is 500 and 1,000. So totally 1,500, but the customer made a payment of 100 and then 1,000. So this is where it gets tricky because the payment made by the first payment made by the customer is less than this invoice amount, but the second payment is greater than this invoice amount. So now in order to write the formula, remember the logic. So the logic is going to be find the minimum of available payment amount or the required invoice amount. Whichever is the lower is going to be the result of the formula. So now let's start writing the formula so that it becomes clearer. So what we're going to do is to first find out what is the available payment amount. So the available payment amount would be first the total, how much the customer has paid so far. So that means sum if, and then we are going to go into the payment thing and then say, we don't need this part. We'll just go and do customer, comma, which is very similar to the previous formula we wrote. So now instead of invoice number, I have to do customer because we are doing everything by customer now. And then the sum range will be the payment amount by the customer, and then do this. Okay. So now this is the total amount that the customer has paid. So customer one has paid $1,100. And then the problem with this is that now the $1,100 will get allocated every time the customer one appears, it'll allocate $1,100. Every time the customer two appears, it'll allocate $700 because this formula will give the total amount paid. But we want to subtract amount that has already been allocated to previous invoices. So this is the part which is a little bit complicated. So I'm gonna hit Alt Enter, and then I'm gonna do minus. And then we will do a SUMIF again. So in the SUMIF, what we are going to do is to use the offset function. So we'll do offset. Offset requires a starting point. So I will start from here, the customer header, and then comma, how many rows should I go? Zero, how many columns should I go? Zero, comma, and then what's the height of my range? And this is where I'm going to use a row function to say, this is our current row, right? That's where we are writing the formula. So current row minus row of the header, which is this. And now this, when I close the parenthesis, so this gives me the range of all the customers until now. So it will not include the current cell, current row, it'll include all the previous rows. So for all the previous rows of customers, I'm gonna copy this part because it'll be helpful for me. And I'm gonna do comma, and the SUMIF requires a criteria. So what are we looking for? We want to know that exactly the rows only where this customer is there. So I'm gonna click in here and that becomes at customer. And now I'll do a comma again. And now what are we going to sum up? We're going to sum up all the paid amount column in previous rows. In all the previous rows, we want that. So this is where I'm going to just paste what I copied earlier, which is our offset function. The only thing which is going to be different here is we're not going to start from the customer header. We're going to start from the paid amount column header. So it'll start from here and it'll go all the way and it'll stop before the current row. And we'll use an actual example to illustrate that better, but I'm gonna close the SUMIF now and let's check if the SUMIF closes, correct? Okay, so now we have closed the SUMIF. So this tells us all the allocated amount, the total thing will give us the allocated amount, this one, and then this one is the total paid by the customer. So total paid minus total allocated will give us how much can we be allocating to this invoice? So I'm going to hit enter. So we'll see what happens here. So all the 1100 has been allocated to the first invoice, and which means for the second invoice, there's nothing to be allocated because we have already allocated all of the paid amounts. Similarly, for customer two, all the $700 have been allocated to this invoice, so nothing is left to be allocated here. So we are going in the right direction, that we don't have the 1100 in both places now. It's only one place. However, you don't want to allocate $1,100 to an invoice which is only 500, right? So that's the last part of the formula, which is to do a minimum function. Say minimum of the whole thing, like this amount, and put a comma, and then say, if the invoice amount is less, then just allocate only the invoice amount. So close parenthesis, hit okay. Now what happens is, the 500 has been allocated to the invoice number one, and then the remaining 600 are allocated to the invoice number two. So 500 now is paid in full, no outstanding amount, but the second invoice, only 600 has been allocated. The remaining 400 amount should be paid by the customer. This is because totally 1100 is what the customer one has paid. Totally 700 is what the customer two has paid. And so 700 is allocated here. Remaining 1,300 is still due, so it is calculating correctly. So just to recap again, what's happening here? We have the sum if. This looks at the total amount that the customer's paid so far, which includes all the payments in the payments by customer table, and then this part is actually calculating what has already been allocated towards previous invoices. So all the previous invoices. Payments made should be subtracted. And so the difference here, now the difference here will tell us how much more can be allocated. And then we compare that with the invoice amount, and then we take the minimum value. So this is the formula that will help us correctly allocate the payments towards multiple invoices. One thing to keep in mind here is that we are using the offset from the top to the bottom, so which means that it'll go in this order. So the order in which it's allocated is based on the order in which you have entered the table. If you have any questions or suggestions about this topic, please post them in the comments, and I look forward to hearing your feedback. I'll see you all in the next week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.